What up, Marsh Pod mobile version? On this Friday morning, we're recording this fresh off of. I've had three different days, I've had three plates of Thanksgiving food. And let me just tell you, I am about done with it. Love Thanksgiving. Big friend environment for me. My family doesn't live where I live, so it's a big friend environment, which is great. But let me just say, I am done eating turkey and stuffing for 12 months. Turkey is kind of tough, man. Like, it is so easy to do it bad. And I'm just going to come on and tell you, 0 for 3 on turkey. Very dry this year for me. Now, I didn't cook it. I'm not baking the cookie or the turkey, but whoever was left it in a touch long. But that's not what we're here for. We're here for we're 1+ week and a half now from the start of the season. We're gonna bring back pointless power rankings because they're pointless. But we're basically gonna do a top five. But we're making it related to the holiday, and we're building a plate of teams of our top five based off what I prefer to eat at Thanksgiving. So our top five food items, in no particular order, but apple pies first, turkey, stuffing, corn casserole, sweet potato casserole, and of course apple pie. That's our top five. Again, no particular order here. I just built the plate and filled in the team names. Will not be eating any cranberry sauce. I don't know how people like that, homemade or not. Stuff's gross. Green beans themselves, they're hit or miss. I'm sorry, it's a holiday meal. I'm not getting all my all my veggies in, although I wish we could get some more protein. But again, we'll stop talking about food because that's not what we're here for. All right, let's start off with turkey. Again, no particular order, but this is a top five. Turkey is beast of the East. That's your staple. That's your meal, man. That is what you build your plate around. It's often the first thing in the buffet line if you're doing buffet family style, or if you're doing buffet style. It's the thing everyone's reaching for if you're plate and everything. So turkey, they're beasts. Why? Randy Champs, they bring back a solid core. 11 colors, that guy in the paint. I think they've got a lot of pieces on that that could really blossom into offensive scoring weapons to fill the void left by Fareed Redmond. Great coach, head on his shoulders. They're the top team in my book. Stuffing, box stuffing, because I don't like that homemade stuff, because I'm a shill for craft. So stuffing, we're going Queen City Kings, because that team has got about every little piece that you could possibly imagine. You need a big man inside, we got Nick Hugo. You need somebody outside to shoot the ball, guess what, we got Sky Durant on the wing. Oh, you need somebody to operate, we got Renzo Bryan. They've got every single thing that you could imagine. The only thing stuffing don't got is protein, but you could probably chop up some ham and put it in that and call it the same thing. So Queen City Kings, I know Coach Skinny says they're an underdog. I know he thinks they're the 31st ranked team in the league, only better than Middle East. Coach, you're just not. That's a top five team right there. All right, number three, corn casserole. Oh, geez. New to the corn casserole game, personally. Had it this year, mostly because I don't think anyone made it. That was popping off. Earmuffs. That was popping off. So corn casserole, OGs, they've got what you need. You got Cooper Flagg and Big Vic inside. That's a talented big man duo. I don't know that there's going to be a better one in the paint. I'll hear the Kearney-Cutler combo, you know, Carter and Hugo in Queen City. There's some good ones, but I don't think anything's beating Flagg and Big Vic right here. That's the number three team for me. Number four, sweet potato casserole, especially if you've got a little glaze on top. Ooh, Rocky Mountain. This team is bringing back everything. I still have a huge believer in Justin Bell. I'm not sure why that guy is not in the top 15 anymore, now ranked 30th. That's by 24/7. That's just the one I go to. He's a dynamic player, and they didn't really lose much outside of some shooting, which I think they've brought back. So you've got him and Lucas Banks to anchor this thing. That is going to be one of the toughest teams to slow down for a full season. So very high on Rocky Mountain. Then five, apple pie, H-Town Hoopers. Coach Pilardi has proven time and time again that he can take a adequate big man and make him great. And now he's going to get a great one in Corey Yans, at least in theory. I love everything about Corey's game. We saw the flashes of it. Bilardi, I think, is the type of guy that's going to be able to extract those flashes and make them a long-term piece. So for H-Town, yeah, I understand this team is kind of rebuilt. They're bringing back very few pieces from last year. But you bring in J-Mo, you bring in Corey Yams. Winning at the highest level, you need the top guy. You need a number one guy. It doesn't have to be 25 points per game, right? It can be Fareed Redmond and Levin Cutler. 10 to 13 points per game. They do some things great, but they arrive at the biggest moments. I think they've got the pieces there that can do that. That's apple pie. That's H-Town Hoopers. All right, reminder, it is the 24th of November. Starting next week, you only get one podcast to listen to of my sorry self. That'll be on Mondays at 2 p.m. But we'll be back on the broadcasts once the games start on the 1st of December. So we'll see you then. And yeah, we can't wait, man. We can't wait. The season is finally here. It's about damn time. All right, we will talk to you on Monday.